Hi there, this is Emmanuel. Welcome to my channel. In this video, we are going to talk about some UI challenges from Flutter for Fun weblog. This is the third one and the fourth one. As you might know, in Flutter for Fun, I had some blog posts, UI challenges, and I decided to continue it as some videos in my YouTube channel. So before that, I would like to have an overview over the past blog post that I already have, and then we can have our new UI challenge videos. So I would start with the third one. This is a gaming app by Tanmoy Roy, if I'm pronouncing it correctly, and you can find his profile in OpLab. I will put the link into the description. So it's a fancy UI that he implemented. We have two pages. In the first page, we have some characters in a vertical list, and in each row, we have two containers or something like that, two rectangles. And on top of that, we have a character as an image, and also we have some attributes or properties or something like that that is circular, and also we have a button here. So in the second page, we have the character in the larger size, and we have some text here and two buttons. So let's get started with the character and the rectangles behind it. So to implement this shape, we need to transform a container, a normal container. We can wrap our simple container with a transform widget. So with a transform widget, you can do some transforms on your widget. For example, you can rotate your widget, you can scale it, you can translate it to move it somewhere else, or you can rotate it. For example, in this sample, we are rotating the y-axis, so it works like this. As you see, here we have a slider, and you can see the effect. And here is the dart pad sample, but because this code is too old, you cannot run it. It is for around 3 years ago. If you have time, you can contribute to the project. This is open source, and you can migrate it to the newer Flutter version. I would be thankful. So yeah, the first step, we need to transform the container. And here, for example, we added the border radius and we rotated the shape with 5 degrees. So you see this shape. And also we do the same to have another one. As you see in the sample, we have two containers that are transformed. And yeah, here we have a stack. This is the first one, and this is the third one. And after that, we need to add our image. So these two are the containers. And here we have the character image, as you see. We just added a normal image loaded from network, and it has a width and height. And in the next step, we implement this attribute or property part. So we can use a custom paint widget. We can use canvas.drawCircle to have a circle behind that, and also two circles with a stroke on top of that to have this circle with opacity, and also this shape which shows how powerful is your attribute. And yeah, so to do that, we have a circle, we have another circle, and on top of that we have an arc, because it is not a full circle, it is a portion of a circle. So we have canvas.drawArc, which draws some part of a circle. We can say, okay, draw this arc from this point to this point, and something like that. So as a result, we have this attribute widget, which has a custom paint with the attribute painter that we already created. And also it accepts a progress. So progress is something between 0 to 1, I think. No, it is 0 to 100. it seems it is 0 to 100, and then you can say, okay, show me the 10% of the arc or of the circle. Also, you can try it in the Dart pad, but I think the code is not available anymore because this blog post is too old. And yeah, in the next step, we just add some text, add some attribute widgets, and as a result, we have this beautiful rose. So we just put the widget that we created into a list to show a vertical list of characters. So yeah, this is the attribute widget that we created in the previous step using a custom paint. And in the next step, we are implementing the item details page, the second page. And here we just have a scaffold, and in the first step, we only create the gradient and the top bar. So to do that, we have a stack widget, we have a safe area because we don't want to have overlap when we want to draw the top bar with the status bar. And we have an icon button, we have a text, and also we have an icon for the menu here. Yeah, this is a simple row widget. And as the decoration, we have linear gradient to have this beautiful gradient from something like red to something like yellow. And in the next step, we are adding three transparent layers. So as you remember, here we have three containers, three transparent containers on top of each other. And on top of all of that, we have an image or the character image. So we need to draw three containers here. This is the first one, this is the second one, and this is the third one. And after that, we put the image inside the third container. So as a result, we have this beautiful shape. We have three containers and an image on top of that. And in the next step, we add this text, the character name, and also we add the description. So to add this text effect, we use a stack widget to overlap two normal text on top of each other. So the first one, this one is the text with the highest opacity or normal opacity. And this one is the same text, but it is in larger size. You see the font size is 56, but this one is 42. And also the opacity is 10%. So we will have this transparent text here. And yeah, after that, we add the buttons and other things, the description and other things are simple. And yeah, this is the final result. We can watch it together. So this is the source code. I will show you, it is in this URL. I will put the link into the description, and this is for 4 years ago. I think this is for when the COVID started. I had a lot of free times in my home and I started this blog. And yeah, so if you want to contribute, I would be happy if you migrate the code to the newer Flutter versions. Then we can have a running sample in the web somewhere, and then people can interact with the UI challenge. And let's get back to the other UI challenge. It is the fourth one. So yeah, Flutter UI challenge for Electron's counter app. So if you remember, in December 2020, there was a challenge called Flutter Counter Challenge 2020. So if you follow this hashtag, you can find a lot of cool samples. And the idea was simple. It was to implement a new method to show the counter app of Flutter, because the default one is boring, and people started to creating a lot of cool samples, and you can find them here. For example, this one, when you tap plus, it changes this number and shows a new image and with this cool effect. And yeah, I like this one. This one is really amazing. It increases the resolution of the image. And yeah, the other one is, I don't remember this one. Yeah, what is this one? Oh, this is Heisenberg. What is this one? Oh, this one is really amazing. When you tap on plus, the position changes somewhere else, and this is like a game, and you have to press 20 times, and yeah, he did it in 11 seconds. And this one, oh, this one has physics. I like this one. Yeah, by the way, you got the idea. The idea was to replace the default counter app with something interesting, because the default one is boring. And yeah, here we have some dashes that look at your mouse. Oh, nice. Yeah, and my submission was this one. I showed some different representation of a number, decimal, binary, octal, and hexadecimal. And yeah, and the other one is this electrons counter. And yeah, the idea is simple. We have some orbits and you can add electrons on them, and yeah, they rotating around the atom here. So yeah, this was the idea behind this implementation, and now I'm going to go through the steps that I went through to implement this animation. At first we need to draw the orbits, so we can use canvas.drawOval to print or to draw this shape. Yeah, it just accepts a rectangle and a paint. So in our paint we say that okay, we need to have a white color with a stroke width of 1, and in the rect we have a rectangle, and it draws the oval inside the rectangle that you provided here. Then we can add each electron inside the oval, so we can calculate the position using cosine and sine functions. And the next step is to rotate the electron over the orbit. So you can see this logic here. We have a custom painter that is implemented in the previous step, and here we have the electron degree, which draws the electron in the degree that we determined here. And here we have a degree which starts at 0 and 0, and we have a timer, and every 16 milliseconds we increase the degree. Then we update the, with the set state, we update the custom paint to update the position of our electron. And yeah, the next step, we add the speed to each electron. So we created a data class that stores the speed, size, color, and current position in degree, just some variables. You see, this is the old code because this @ required doesn't exist anymore. So yeah, you can see that this is the old code. And yeah, so here we have the data class to store the variables and show the electrons. And here we just added some more orbits. So in the first step, we only had one orbit, and here we have two more. So we have 3 orbits in total here. They are rotated using the transform.rotate widget. And in the next step, we implemented a function to add an electron using the plus button. So when you hit the plus button, it adds a new electron. So this is the logic, I think. Yeah, floating action button. And inside the unpressed, we chose a random orbit because we have three orbits, as you remember. And we add an electron inside the selected random orbit. And the speed is a random value between 1 and 3. Size is a random value between 4 and 8. And also we have a random color. And it starts from the 0 degree. And yeah, so the point is that when you create a new electron, we want to notify user that, oh, there's a new electron here created and started rotating. As you see, it starts with a larger size and then it decreases to a normal size and started rotating. So to do that, we created these properties, target size and current size. When we create the electron, the current size can be a larger value, but the target size is something that it decreases and stays the same at the target size. For example, here we say that, okay, target size is the normal size, but the current size, which is the starting size, is something times 10. So as you see, when you create a new electron, it starts with a larger size and it decreases to the normal size. And yeah, that's it. So we have the Dart pad here, we have the GitHub source code here, and I would be happy if you have time to contribute to the project, then you can migrate it to be able to run with the newer Flutter versions. Then we can deploy the web somewhere and people can use it and interact with it. And yeah, in the next step, we are going to take a look at the other UI challenges. I think the fifth one and the sixth one. So stay tuned for the next video. Don't forget to subscribe my channel and hit the like button, and see you, bye.